Now, Solyndra, Governor Romney goes out to Solyndra, makes this, takes some questions out there, makes the point about the $500 million taxpayer investment. Earlier this week, Jay Carney was asked about the difference between Bain, the attacks on Bain Capital, and the investment in Solyndra. Here's his answer.
There is the difference in that your overall view of what your responsibilities are as president and what your view of the economic future is. And the president believes, as he's made clear, that a president's responsibility is not just to those who win, but those who, in, for an example, in a company where there have been layoffs or a company that's gone bankrupt, that you know, we have to make sure that those folks have the means to find other employment.
Okay, Charles.
I can't decide if that's incoherent or a non sequitur, probably both or combination. Look, he had no answer to that. The answer is that if you're the president in Solyndra, you can hand out unlimited amounts of money, especially to your cronies, and you don't suffer if anything happens, if it goes bust, except the people involved do. Whereas if you're in private enterprise and you invest and you lose, as we in the private economy, it's different. That's why we have a private economy that produces growth and that produces wealth and has been for 200 years, and why the money usually siphoned off by the government in crony capitalism is a failure. And we've seen that on a massive scale historically in socialist economics and capitalist economics. I mean, there's no comparison. But you've got to ask yourself, on today's events, who is David Axelrod and who elected him? I mean, who decided he should stand outside the courthouse and give a speech? You know, he's a advisor of the president. He has no stature. I think that looked pretty bad, drowned out. And why wouldn't you? If you have the vice president of the United States speaking, well, he's a guy who won an election, a national election, or a surrogate who's elected. I think that's a pretty lousy choice. The other thing is the strategic. Obama is jeopardizing something by going after Romney, first on Bain, now on the governorship, through surrogates, but often himself. He's squandering, for tactical advantage, he's squandering the one advantage an incumbent has, which is something that is incomparable. The presidential aura, the guy who's above it all, he's never going to have the transcendence of the Obama of 08, but if he's going to get down there and act like any other politician and sling stuff so early on, it's going to hurt him in a way that he won't be able to repair.
But Dana, to Juan's point, the campaign is betting that they define Romney for folks who don't know him yet. And this segment of this time in May is the time that they're spending doing that.
Interestingly, I think a lot of people feel like we still don't understand or know who President Obama is. He's still to be defined. And if you look at Victor Davis, David Hansen, who wrote in National Review this week, he gets to be all things to all people. He's both the deficit cutter, but also the person who invests in Solyndra. He's a stimulus guy, and then again, the person that wants to cut back and be more responsible. So I understand what they're trying to do, and I think it's smart when it comes to Romney, but I have to agree with Charles. I thought that photograph with David Axelrod, it was just bizarre, and I almost thought it was like a trial balloon. If they said, who wants to go to Massachusetts and give a speech to go against Romney's record and see how it goes, that nobody raised their hand, it was like, okay, I'll go and do it. Because I thought it looked very strange, and it will be forgotten by noon tomorrow.
One.